वेलकम लर्नर्स, व्यूअर्स, स्टूडेंट्स एंड द क्यूरियस. आई एम गोइंग टू मेक अ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन दिस डॉक्यूमेंट हियर ऑन योर स्क्रीन. दिस इज फ्रॉम पार्क हाइट गोवा. आई जस्ट चेक्ड द वेबसाइट ऑफ दिस लवली होटल, लवली रिसोर्ट, एंड आई फाउंड दैट दिस हैज नाउ बीन कन्वर्टेड इन टू ITC ग्रैंड गोवा. And Park Hyatt Goa, it seems, has shut its doors permanently. Nevertheless, this beautiful hotel document will help the first year students to understand a hotel services, how a hotel offers its services, amenities, facilities to its guests, how it is presented. So without wasting much time, let me move on. I think this is a scan of that document. I would call it a brochure, a resort brochure. And Park Hyatt Goa Resort and Spa. So I think resort, we all understand, is a hotel which is designed for vacationers, holiday makers, mostly for families. And a spa traditionally was a place where a traveler would visit to gain health benefits. So a spa in a resort means there would be some facilities, some treatment, medical treatment, activities that would help people regain their level of fitness and rejuvenate themselves. So I'll move on to the next page of this document and zoom in for you so that it's all very clear. So I'll read it, and wherever there is a difficulty, in my opinion, I'll explain it. Park Hyatt Goa Resort and Spa is set on a 45 acres campus on Arosim Beach in South Goa, and is 15 minutes from Dabolim Airport. To the discerning traveler, discerning means somebody who is discriminating, somebody who is very choosy, very careful about their selection. They are called, known as discerning travelers. So to the discerning traveler, the hotel redefines luxury and gracious service with sophisticated accommodation. Sophisticated is like accommodation that is designed intelligently with the needs of the traveler in mind. While to the spa enthusiasts are people who are interested in spa treatment activities, it is the ultimate sanctuary for rejuvenation and relaxation. So what is rejuvenation? Rejuvenation is like somebody who is very tired physically, emotionally, mentally. So they undergo this treatment, this experience, and at the end of the process, they feel recharged, re-energized, calm, relaxed, and raring to go. In fact, that is what a holiday is supposed to do. And now we would look at the facilities which this hotel had to provide, Park Hyatt Goa. Accommodation, a total of 248, beautifully appointed. Appointed means furniture, fixture, the carpet, the works, the bathroom, the tapestry, all these things would include 12 suites. So out of 248 rooms, 12 were suites, the most expensive rooms in the hotel. Elegant Indo-Portuguese pousadas. I think pousadas is confusing for most of us. Pousada is, of course, a Portuguese term, and it comes from the Portuguese word for rest. So it's kind of a rest house, but technically a pousada is something similar to a heritage hotel of India. So these pousadas are luxury accommodation, luxury hotels built in old palaces, old castles, old forts. So that's what a pousada is. So it's an elegant Indo-Portuguese pousadas that showcase Goa's charm and rich cultural heritage. I think those of us who are still not aware, Goa was a Portuguese colony. So Goa has a lot of Portugal's influence, including food, religion, lifestyle, clothes, everything. Standard room measures approximately 41 square meter. So this will help you remember what a standard room size should be. So approximately 8 meters by 5 meters, and you also should be able to convert it into inch and centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters, and 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. So use this for converting the sizes into feet, inch, and of course 12 inches is equal to 1 feet. 1 foot, I'm sorry. All rooms feature a large veranda or balcony. A veranda, balcony, also known as patio in Hawaii. That is how we get that term patio. So patios are rooms that are open from three sides, and they often have a beautiful view of a garden, a lawn, or a seaside, lakeside, something like that. So it is good to sit there and lounge. All room features a spa-inspired sunken bath. Spa-inspired means those hot water springs which contain sulfur in the water, and that is what gives it the warmth, the hotness. And sulfur is supposed to have therapeutic value. It cures skin diseases. So sunken bath is something like a spring. Like in Bihar, we have those hot springs at Rajgir. So something similar. Sunken bath, where you can like lie low and immerse yourself in hot water bath for some time. Some rooms have outdoor shower areas with a secret garden. So which means every room would have its own particular garden which cannot be seen from outside. And this room, this space can be used for taking shower, for generally sunbathing, relaxation. Room amenities include complimentary high-speed internet access. Complimentary is, of course, free of charge. 22-inch LCD screen, LED screen, maybe. I do not know how old this document is. Maybe 2018-17 this document should be. In-room safe is safety locker, which opens with a password. Minibar is a mini fridge, which contains both complimentary items as well as chargeable or payable items. For example, alcohol would be payable and mineral water would be complimentary. Two telephone lines each room will have, and of course, tea coffee maker. Tea coffee generally in hotels is complimentary. Check-in time is 3 p.m. and check-out time is 12 noon. So this I think is a wonderful new tradition which hotels have started following, is that there's a gap between check-in check-out time so that hotel gets sufficient time to prepare the rooms for new arrivals. Previously it was just 12 o'clock check-in check-out both, and it used to create unpleasantness, especially during rush hours during peak season. Okay, so as we go down here, services and facilities, a business center. So even though it is a resort, it's a spa, it still has a thought of providing business center, because obviously it's only the rich and powerful who can afford to holiday. And even on a holiday, I'm sure their concerns related to business is never reduced or eliminated. And therefore, they need a way to connect to their work, to their business. So a resort also has a business center. So this is again a very interesting observation in this document. Facilities for the disabled, facilities like wheelchair, like a ramp, then the grips, the railings for holding, the ramps. I mean, all these things are facilities for disabled. So Park Spa is enabled for disabled. ATM facility, I think I don't need to explain. Currency exchange is for foreign exchange, foreign money. So we can convert our currency into Indian currency if we are a foreigner. Then the other facilities include 24-hour in-room dining. So that is lovely. You can eat whenever you wish or have tea or coffee. It also has laundry and dry cleaning services. Of course, that is not 24 hours, limited time. Transport service, either for airport transfer or local sightseeing or intercity transfer, all these things would be available here. A concierge is a specialist who assists the guest with their requirements outside the resort, outside the hotel. So things like getting a reservation in a fancy restaurant, getting cinema tickets, these things are responsibility of the concierge. Even organizing a babysitter is done by the concierge. The next facilitating factor is babysitting facilities on request. So if you ask for it, you will get a babysitter, which have to be paid on an hourly basis. They often are either young students or housewives who do it for some extra income. Safety deposit facilities. We also had in-room safe, and this one is separate from that in-room safe. This is a separate facility maintained in the back area of front office, and this also is often free. So guests can keep their valuables here. Boutique shops are shops which sell exclusive items, limited items. I think what we need to understand or differentiate it from is mass market. Mass market is, you know, when we produce something en masse, a large number of products, and the idea is low margin, high volume. But boutique business is just opposite of that. We only produce limited quantity of product or goods, and we sell it at a premium. We sell it at a high price, so that the customers are assured that what they're going to buy. Let's say they're buying clothes, so they are assured that the kind of shirt or dress that they are buying, they would not find many people wearing the same dress in a party. So that is what the appeal of a boutique is. They always sell limited editions of anything, be it a shop, be it a jewelry, be it a watch, anything. A major credit cards accepted. I think that we understand. Restaurants and bars. A village square, that's the name of the outlet. It is an al fresco dining area. Al fresco is outdoors in the open air. So dining in the open air outside a demarcated confined room is called al fresco dining. And that includes the resorts, restaurants and retail shops. So what that means is that your food can come from other outlets and you can consume your food in al fresco. So some people enjoy eating out in the open air. Casa Sarita, I hope my pronunciation is correct. Casa is like house. Sarita, I'm not sure, maybe it's a name. Signature fine dining Goan restaurant. So Goan cuisine has a very strong Portuguese influence, and many dishes have that Portugal influence. So Goan restaurant will have typical dishes from Goa. The Luigi or Luigi or Luigi is a casual home style Italian trattoria. Trattoria is one level below a restaurant in Italy. Restaurants are like full service outlets, something like fine dining, where you'll have, you know, a very efficient, skilled waiter taking care of your dining needs, and of course trained chefs as well. But trattoria is often run by a family, and in fact the grandmother or the grandfather, who is the expert cook in the family, he would actually be cooking in the kitchen of this restaurant. Now I do not know whether this would also have somebody from Italy making preparations, but the atmosphere, the decor is similar to what an Italian trattoria would look like. So it is not informal, but it is not as formal as restaurant either. So that is what we need to understand what trattoria is. Masala is North Indian specialty kitchen. So North Indian could mean Punjabi, it could also mean Mughalai. So I'm not very sure what exactly it would be. Village cafe. Cafe is where you get coffee and snacks all day, 24 hours. This is of course all day, not all night dining restaurant. Palms is a beachside grill and seafood restaurant. I think grill is that metal structure underneath which we have fire, live fire, and we cook often large cuts of meat and even seafood, sea items like lobster, crabs. These are grilled. So these
These
items
items
will
will have
have
that
that
impression
impression
of
of
that
that
grill,
grill,
that
that
square
square grill,
grill,
the
the net-like
net-like
impression
impression
on
on
the
the
meat.
meat.
So
So
that
that
is
is
what
what
a
a
grill
grill
is,
is,
cooking
cooking
meat
meat
on
on
a
a
live
live
fire
fire
and
and
of
of
course
course
seafood
seafood
restaurant.
restaurant.
Poolside
Poolside
bar
bar
is
is
like
like
a
a
bar
bar
situated
situated
beside
beside
swimming
swimming
pool.
pool.
It
It
may
may
have
have
a
a
place
place
to
to
sit.
sit.
It
It
may
may
also
also
have
have
that
that
poolside
poolside
deck
deck
chair,
chair,
lounge
lounge
chair
chair
where
where
you
you
can
can
lie
lie
down
down
and
and
sip
sip
your
your
drink.
drink.
Offers
Offers
exotic
exotic
cocktails
cocktails
and
and
snacks.
snacks.
I
I
think
think
cocktails
cocktails
first
first
years
years
will
will
only
only
learn
learn
in
in
second
second
year.
year.
It
It
is
is
in
in
secondary
secondary
syllabus.
syllabus.
So
So
a
a
cocktail
cocktail
is
is
a
a
mixed
mixed
drink
drink
which
which
contains
contains
some
some
alcoholic
alcoholic
content
content
and
and
some
some
non-alcoholic
non-alcoholic
content.
content.
For example, a Bloody Mary would include vodka with tomato juice. Then there are drinks which combine rum with cola. There are many variations of cocktails, and in second year you would get a hang of it. So now moving on to the next page of this document and zooming in. So these are some lovely images from Park Hyatt, Goa. They look picturesque, beautiful, idyllic, in fact. So we were covering restaurants and bars. Praia da Luz, I think the translation I tried to check, it means the beach maybe. So an elegant lounge bar offering fine wines and appetizers. Lounge is a place where you can relax comfortably. It often has great seating, a great view, great music, and a great F&B service. So lounge bar offering fine wines and appetizers. Appetizers are tasty tidbits that are spicy, salty, savory, and they are meant to increase your appetite. So many people have it before their meals. Wine rooms is a private dining space for a small gathering. So it's like a group can have their own party in this space, and they would also be able to order alcohol there. So wine rooms are private dining areas for small gatherings. Now, cabanas here is explained as a romantic dinner setting on Arosim Beach. We all know that cabanas are changing rooms. That's what we learned in first year. So cabanas are again situated either near the swimming pool or near the sea beach. But this space is only hired on an hourly basis. And therefore, in the evening when nobody is using it for changing or relaxing, this place could be converted to a restaurant or romantic dinner setting, I think is a beautiful idea. So it's a great innovation I have noticed here. A cabana being used to serve dinner at night, where it would be lying useless anyway. So I think this is a very smart managerial idea to make the maximum use of a facility. Recreation facilities is like something like entertainment facilities, time pass facilities and activities. One of India's largest outdoor swimming pools with water slides. I think water slides, you understand. You start from a height and then slide through and splurge into the water. That is water slides. An outdoor whirlpool. Whirlpool is similar to jacuzzi or a hot tub. So whirlpools have that pressure jets and they release water at some pressure. And the water at pressure, when it falls on your body at various joints, at various muscles, it kind of massages you, relaxes you. And since it is warm, so it also enhances blood circulation and it improves your health. So whirlpool, jacuzzi is same. Children's pool would be shallow so that nobody drowns in it, would be smaller. But it would be deep enough so that if somebody can swim, they can swim. The pristine Arosim Beach. Pristine is something which is unpolluted, undisturbed, not dirtied, perfectly clean, perfect for sunbathing and water sports. So what water sports they have, I have no idea. But things like water skiing would be there. Anything else, you need to find out. Archery, the bow and arrow game. Beach volleyball, where you know, only two people on both sides play, is a small court, a beach volleyball. Lawn tennis, I don't need to explain. And an indoor games room. Indoor games room would include, I believe, table tennis, carom board, something else I'm not aware of. A 24-hour fitness center. Now, this is great. So, a health club where there are what we call a gym, a gymnasium, a fitness center. So, it will have all those machines for fitness, including the jogging, jogging mill, jogging trail. And it's open 24 hours so that even if a foreigner comes whose body clock is different from Indian body clock, I mean, for example, if Indian time and American time is different, Indian time and Australian time is different. So their body clock is adjusted on a different duration. So when they come to India, maybe it is day in their country and therefore they may want to exercise at that time. Their body may actually demand it. We need to understand this factor. That's why I'm trying to explain it. That our body is attuned to the body clock we set to. So my 6 o'clock is different from the 6 o'clock in the morning of another country far away from my country. So when it is day in my country, it may be night in their country. And when it is night in my country, it may be day in their country. So their body will demand facilities, services according to their own body clock and not according to Indian times. And that is why it's a very smart idea to have a 24-hour fitness center so that people can use it whenever they feel the need to. Camp Hyatt, an exclusive facility for children up to 12 years of age, featuring indoor and outdoor recreational activities. So this is for children, and all kind of games would be there. Sereno Spa. Sereno, I think, is serene. Sereno is like very peaceful. So Sereno Spa would be a Portuguese word where people can have massage, Ayurvedic treatment, or other therapies if there are. The size of 36,000 square feet, which is roughly equal to 3,344.5 square meters. Destination spa overlooking the Arabian Sea. What is destination spa? It means the spa is supposed to be so attractive, so famous, that some people would visit this place only to utilize the services of a spa. That is what is meant by a destination spa. Similar to destination wedding, there are many places in the world where people just travel to get married. So now moving on to the next side of this page. 9 indoor spa suites. So spa also has suites for massage, for therapies, and 7 outdoor spa pavilions, which means it will be outside in the open. Some offer an outdoor plunge pool. A plunge pool is a smaller and shallower version of swimming pool. Swimming pool is large and it is meant for swimming, but plunge pool is just I think for recreation. You can just sit down there and do some physical exercise activities. Physiotherapy can be conducted in water. So a plunge pool is a very small swimming pool. Often the size is 8 feet by 8 feet, but it could become larger also, and it could be as large as 8 feet by 16 feet. And a private shower with steam facility. So, which means after your spa treatment, you may want to have your own, you may want to take bath. And steam facility is a steam bath facility where people are exposed to hot steam. And that steam is supposed to, cleanse our skin, open the body pores, and make our, the dead skins softer to clean away. And after a steam bath, after a sauna treatment, our skin is generally scrubbed clean and we actually start glowing and shining. So a steam bath, a steam facility is much preferred by people to rejuvenate their skin and their appearance. Holistic treatments and therapies inspired by ancient Ayurvedic and yogic traditions. So this spa relies on Ayurveda and yoga for its therapies and treatments. And Kerala has made a name for itself in this area. Lifestyle consultations, which means there are experts, maybe nutrition experts, dietitians, maybe there are psychiatrists, other people who would advise us on developing a better lifestyle. Yoga session, meditation session, I think I don't need to explain this. All Indians understand these two things. A spa boutique is where you can actually buy clothing, footwear or anything similar for your spa treatment. So a spa boutique, if you are not carrying your own clothing, apparel for spa treatment, then you can get your spa apparel. For example, yoga mats, for example, that gowns, yoga gowns, could be purchased from spa boutique. Now, the next is visitor information. So anyone who is visiting Goa should be aware of the climate. So Goa has a pleasant and warm climate throughout the year, which means it never is very cold, very chilled, and no snowfall, of course, with frequent showers from June to September. So June to September is the time when Goa has heavy shower and thunderstorm as well. And since I've done my training at Goa, so I know that that is the off season in Goa. March to May, temperature is 24 to 34 maximum. So it is mostly pleasant. And if you remember your geography classes, sea breeze and land breeze, then you will realize that all the coastal areas, they often have, you know, a very balanced temperature throughout the year. And that is why they are preferred by people to live. They never have extreme climate. And that is also the speciality of Goa. June to September is monsoon season, minimum 24, maximum 32. And then we have October to February is minimum 21 and maximum 28. So I think this is the peak season of Goa. This is when maximum tourists, Indian as well as foreign, visit Goa. And this also includes the Christmas and New Year's period. Voltage is 220 volts, so that people, if in their own country the voltage is something different, then they will have to use adapters, otherwise their devices may be spoiled. So this information is very critical so that people do not spoil their laptops, their smartphones, expensive smartphones, because of wrong voltage or mismatched voltage in Indian power supply. Currency of India, of course, is the Indian rupee, and we have to but specify it for legal reasons. And we are also saying that all visitors require a valid Indian visa. So we are stating these two things from a legal perspective. I think that is the end of this document. No. This document also has a small map of Goa and giving a brief idea where, like for example, airport is here and Park Hyatt is down south.